Hi everybody, Jewel here with your tropical update, and this in at 2:10 this afternoon. Air Force Reserve Hurricane Hunters find Zeta has strengthened to a hurricane. Now, the data from the Air Force Reserve Hurricane Hunter aircraft is indicating that Zeta has become a hurricane with maximum sustained winds near 80 miles per hour with higher gusts. It's located at 19.4 north, 85.8 west. Now, it's about 105 miles southeast of Cozumel, Mexico. Now, it's looking like these winds are 80. We do have some higher gusts. The movement is northwest at around 10 miles per hour. And the pressure now is 28.97 inches. As we look at the latest satellite data, you can see right here. Here is Zeta right in here, moving slowly over the peninsula area here. Epsilon, no problem to anyone. It's going to move on out to sea. Now, what you see here is just a low pressure system. It shouldn't turn into anything. Should bring rain to the islands here in Puerto Rico, possibly. But Jamaica, you're going to be getting rain if you haven't already felt some, which you probably have, from Zeta. You're going to feel some more as it moves on along. Zeta, well, you can see what it's looking like. It's a pretty well-formed storm now. It is a Category 1, but don't let that trick you. It's going to still bring storm surge, rainfall, and wind impacts from Louisiana to the Florida Panhandle. And everyone in these areas, please stay up on what happens to Zeta, because you need to pay attention to your local authorities. You need to watch your local forecast. If you are anywhere down around Pennsylvania, Mississippi, Alabama, and the Florida Panhandle, Zeta is going to be bringing rain over all the way over into Georgia. And by the latter part of the week, South Carolina and North Carolina is going to be getting rain from Zeta also. Taking a quick look at the National Hurricane Center's tracking center here, you can see what's going on. Should be still having some hurricane strength. We got to see what happens tomorrow, because we're going to be having a big high over here, and we're going to be having an upper low system over here. Now, these two systems are what's going to be steering this. If this high moves on out and this low proceeds across, it should move a little bit further over in the eastern sections here. But right now, it's looking like it's coming right up through here and through Biloxi, all the way up. And Mobile, you're going to feel some of it too. Now, you see down in the red, well, that's a hurricane warning. It's in effect for Tulum and Desalam and Cozumel, Mexico. Now, the blue, that's tropical storm warning that's in effect from Pena del Rio, Cuba, south of Tulum to Punta Allen, west of Desalam to Progreso. Now, watches and warnings are going to be coming up probably late tonight or possibly tomorrow at some point for the Gulf Coast states of Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, and parts of the Florida Panhandle. So please, everybody in these areas, keep up with your local weather forecasts, keep up with your local authorities. Don't get caught short with Hurricane Zeta. I'm going to try to make this just as short as I can, but get the information out that you need to know, folks. Thanks so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. For any kind of weather you need to know about, I'll have it for you. Click subscribe, click the bell, and make sure you check off all to make sure you get all my latest videos. Now, most of the time I use the European model, but with Hurricane Zeta, I'm leaning towards the American model, the GFS, and this is where it's at around this time of the day. It's set at 4 p.m., and I'm on the eastern seaboard, so we'll move it up just a little bit here to around 10 p.m. tonight. You can see how it's moving along. Now, I want you to pay attention to something I'm going to show you and try to point out to you in just a moment. Now, we got this high pressure going on right in here. Well, now you can also see the high pressure ends here, and then the low pressure starts. Now, it's going to keep moving around. We'll go to 4 p.m. Tuesday afternoon, tomorrow afternoon, and you can see it a little better now, okay? Now, this is going to be moving through. This high pressure is pushing. That's what is making it go a little more to the westerly side of the Gulf at the moment. I got a feeling, though, that this upper-low system is going to push it on over a little bit. We'll have to wait and see. Let's get to Wednesday. And Wednesday, and especially Wednesday night and early Thursday morning, is when you guys are really going to start to feel this. I've checked on some of the winds. Some of the winds are going to be 70, 80 miles per hour as it comes on shore, and that goes for Biloxi. You could have 69 to 70 mile per hour winds. Mobile, you should have 50 to 60 mile per hour winds as it comes in. And around the Florida Panhandle, you're looking mostly at around 39 mile per hour winds with this storm. So we'll move on through now to 4 p.m. Wednesday afternoon. You can see it's moving up, and see how this low pressure over here, see how it's kind of scooted over from where it was. This high pressure's let up. As you can see, the low pressure, that upper low that I'm talking about, is in control now, and it's pulling it on up, and it's going to pull it out right around in this area as it makes landfall. Now, this isn't a guarantee. We're looking at this. This is just something good to go by. It doesn't mean it's going to come and land right here, but let's check out the coordinates from the National Hurricane Center and see what it looks like. Before we do that, though, while we're over here at the model, let's check out, you've heard a lot of people talk about another system that may form. Well, right now, this is just an elongated low pressure, and this is on Election Day for the U.S., Tuesday, November 3rd, early in the morning at 7 a.m. It's right here. We'll move it along to that afternoon. You can see it's trying to get a little action going on. Still no tightly compacted isobars around it, but it does have some wind gusts right here. Let's see what they are. 38 knots. We'll put that in miles per hour for everybody so you can get a better grip on it. 44 mile per hour winds. It could be a tropical storm. We'll have to wait and see if it develops, though. It's still out a little over a week from now. We'll see what happens. If it does form, it's Eta. This one's Zeta. Who knows? They don't go in order, huh? Moving right along as far as we can go up to November 4th at 9 p.m. This is where it's at right here. We can see what's going on. These wind gusts are still at tropical storm force. We will check out sustained winds. Sustained winds. Well, it still has some pretty good sustained winds in it at 37, but that's not tropical storm. Got to be 39. We'll see what the rain looks like with it. If it does happen to form, well, it does have some good clusters of rain in it, especially moving over Jamaica. Jamaica, you're going to get the rain, and you will get whatever wind this brews up. I'll keep my eyes on it. It's still a ways out. We got to wait and see what happens, but I did want to point this out to you. Now, with the latest coordinates from the National Hurricane Center, before landfall, right before landfall, where the most people are going to get the most winds when it comes in, you can see where it's located, right here where this is. Here's Cocoa Dryer, Louisiana. We have New Orleans up here looking like it's probably going to go right past New Orleans this way. That's what it's looking like. Yes, New Orleans, you will get wind, you will get rain. The worst should be on this side of the map, though. And as it moves on across, you can see how it's going to move on up across to Gulfport and Biloxi. The wind and rain, not severe wind, but some good gust and a lot of rain is going to be felt all the way to Mobile, Alabama. So here's Mobile right here as it moves on through. Everybody who is on the eastern side of this storm will catch the most of it. But this is what it's looking like right now. Who knows, folks, when we get up in the morning, it may be totally different. But this is what it's looking like now, according to the National Hurricane Center, of where it may make landfall. The key things that everybody needs to know. Hurricane conditions and dangerous storm surge are expected in portions of the northern Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico tonight and early tomorrow. Tropical storm conditions could occur over extreme western Cuba beginning late this afternoon or tonight. Now through Tuesday, expect heavy rain from Zeta across the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, the Cayman Islands, and central to western Cuba. Now, this rainfall may lead to flash flooding in urban areas. Between Tuesday night and Thursday, heavy rainfall is expected from portions of the central United States Gulf Coast into the southern Appalachians and mid-Atlantic states near and in advance of Zeta. Now, this rainfall could lead to flash urban small stream and some minor river flooding. It's looking like we know they were saying here it's going to be near hurricane strength when it approaches the northern Gulf Coast Wednesday. I think it will be. There is that slight chance from that upper level low system coming down to cause some wind shear. Now, if that occurs, we'll find out tomorrow if that's looking like what's going to happen. It may bring Zeta down in the wind speeds. A little, but it's still going to be a high-end tropical storm if that occurs. There's no dry air to interfere with it. The water will be a little cooler right around the borders of the land where it should make landfall, but it's still looking like it's going to be a hurricane. We're going to have to wait and see if that wind shear progresses and materializes from that upper level low. So that's a quick check of Zeta. The other system that may occur starting next Tuesday to form, we'll have to wait and see what happens with that. But once again, I urge everyone from portions of Louisiana, the panhandles of Mississippi, Alabama, and Florida, keep up with Zeta, with your local forecast and your local authorities. If they tell you you might need to move, please do so. I love you guys. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it so much. And don't forget to subscribe, click that bell, check off all to make sure you get all my videos. Have a good evening, a safe evening, and a blessed evening wherever you are. And may each and every one of you stay safe for goodness sakes, and much peace, love, and kindness to all of you. Thank you for watching.